Welcome back to the 27th of Remaking Hotline Miami in Game Maker Studio. And today we're gonna continue on the last part. So basically we clicked on the right, the right mouse button, and then boom, the enemy went to the specific spot, and we're gonna remedy that. So basically the enemy will go at a specific spot, then stay there for a few seconds, and then return to the original position. And of course we're gonna change the hover over emote, so we know at what kind of state we are in, and therefore it's much easier to read from what, from the outside, what's actually happening here. Alrighty, so if you want to know that, stick around. This is OneUp Indie. I am a developer, so if you like what you're seeing, hey, why not consider sharing, liking, and subscribing, and do this for the YouTube algorithm, of course. Alrighty, so let's give it a neat little introduction. This. So basically what we had before, we just said like, hey, we are in the idle state, and then we go to this specific spot, and then we want to give it a different kind of emote. So this one is then used for moving there and back. And then of course, once, for example, we are there and the player is hiding, so basically there's nothing happening, then we just having this question mark and saying like, there's nothing there. Then we just stick around for quite a few seconds, and then we just say, all right, nothing there. And then go back to the same position, have this kind of icon, and then boom, we return to our idle state, and of course change the idle icon. This is the whole idea behind it. So let's do this. Alrighty, so let's go into the project. Where we left off was just basically, we just said like, hey, check out. Here we gonna have a few things extra. First of all, I want to draw something on the screen, which is the start position, which is here. So for example, we stored the start position and the target position. And these ones actually I want to draw as a circle. So this is just, of course, for debugging. So let's just put it under debug, because we don't really actually need it to be all the time drawn. This is just for us, so we know where to start, where to go. And then of course we just say draw a circle, and then here start position X and Y, and then target position X and Y. Just give them different kind of colors, thickness of, so radius of 3, so they are not too big. And because we don't want those dots to be too big, just go, let's say 0.4, then we draw set alpha. Alrighty, so once we start it, so what we are seeing now is basically nothing. We already see the red dot. And then for example, the red dot is the target. Then the green dot is the green, orange dot is the position where we want to go back. All right, so orange. That's why I was just curious why the colors are so kind of strange, but here we need to input the same color for 1 and 2. And then of course you can do some blending if you like, but this is just for debugging. Nothing special. So once again, we need to update our state. For now, for example, we are locked in the checking out state, and this one we're gonna go into. And what can we do besides, well, just what we did? So here once again we just said like, hey, check out user event 0. So we updated the path once, and then dropped it to the next stage. And now we need to say like, hey, at what kind of point are we saying like, hey, we are no longer checking out, we are basically at our destination. And for that we can use something which is called distance to point. So basically we say if distance to point, and then here we input 2 parameters. And for example, what we can actually use is our target position. Just input that, and here this thing will just calculate from us, from our X and Y position. So this is like implicit, and then to these 2 points, and what kind of distance it's having. And say let's say it's smaller than 5 pixels, then we do something. Then we just say like, all right, we arrived at our destination. And what do we want to do that? Well, we just say like, okay, we arrived at there, there's nothing going on, then state nothing there. And then basically we're just sitting around and then doing nothing. And here, once again, this is then basically ending this kind of state. So we just jump into the next state, which would be nothing there. So here we just say like, okay, we arrived at our destination. So what do we do there? We just wait there a few seconds, 3 or 2. What is it? Just basically up to you. And then we just said, okay, there's nothing there. What do we do? And for that, I will introduce more timers. Actually, I don't have any. So I introduce the first timers, which will be nothing there time and nothing there timer. Basically, this one will run down and this one is just basically the reset time. So what do? We just say, hey, nothing there timer in our state, nothing there. It's just running down. And then we say like, hey, if this timer is equal to 0, so basically it ran down, we are there, there's nothing happening. Then we just say, hey, our nothing there timer is equal to nothing there time. So basically this is just resetting those two timers. But then what do? Besides that, we just say, okay, we are there, our timer's running down. So our logical conclusion is we go back. So we just go state going back. And then of course we need to update our user event. And which one is it? Let's check it out. Going back is user event 01. And then we are pretty much finished with this. And then for example, we can basically play the same game as the checking out thing, because we are going back. But once, for example, we are at the same spot where we want to go back, then we need to go back to the idle state. So we once again go into the next stage, the next state, which was going back. So as you can see, this is a logical if statement. And basically we're just checking, okay, at what state we are in. And then, for example, this is the last one. And here, once again, we just say like, hey, if, basically we just can copy paste that thing in there. So if the distance to point is, but not our target, now it is our start point, because we are basically here going back. And then, for example, we need to calculate the distance to our starting point. So here, let's go back. So our starting position, they say like, okay, if the distance to our starting location is smaller than 5 or 3 or 2, doesn't really matter, it's just up to you how close you want to have, then we just say, hey, we are idle. And then we pretty much completed the whole loop and then we are done. So let's check it out. Alrighty, so once again, he is idle. We are pressing go at this specific spot. He's going and he's sticking around. That was kind of 3 seconds. And as you can see, he goes back to the point. But of course, now it all looks like he's all the time idle. So let's remedy that, right? So first of all, we need to say like, hey, at which point we want to change our emote. So every time, for example, we update our path, that would be a good thing to update our emote. So for example, emote once again, here we created it once. So emote, and then for example, we say like, hey, sprite index. Index, basically what kind of sprite we are using. And then for example, if we are checking out, if we are going somewhere, we're using here this one with the arrow, boom, roaming or checking out or going back, it will be basically the same. And here, for example, when we are going back, then we can actually say like, hey, nothing there, the timer ran down. Then let's give it also the same sprite index. And of course, if we are idle, then we say like, hey, sprite index back to idle. And then of course there was one special one, for example, if we are sticking around and nothing is there. So basically we are in our nothing there phase. So here once we are swapping to it, we just say like, hey, nothing is there. And then boom. Well, then we are pretty much finished. So let's check it out. Alrighty, so we are in our idle state. We press the right mouse button. As you can see, we are going to this specific point. Then we say like, okay, we are close, nothing is there. And then we once again go back. And of course, the sticking around, I guess, isn't too long. So maybe I should do this a little bit longer. And as you can see now, we are back in our idle state. So basically, we created our whole loop in under 10 minutes, 10 something. That's a good one. One up in.